begin with the end in mind on this episode of Freedom Friday. Take control. Episode of Freedom Friday, man. I'm just so excited this Friday in particular because tomorrow I'll be headed to my destination of choice, and that is my favorite place in the whole wide world right now, and it is called South Beach, baby. I can't wait to get there. I'll be there for 8 days, so if you'll be there, man, I can't wait to see you there. So today's topic is begin with the end in mind, all right? And you get a lot of these, you know, topics. You know, I read different books, and it's an aspiring national bestseller. It's The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. And this is a great read, definitely. Has a lot of notes and good things that you can use to make yourself a more effective person. And that's one of the topics today, is begin with the end in mind. All right, so what does that mean, you know? It basically means to start with a clear understanding of your destination. So, for instance, I'm headed to South Beach. So, I already have the mindset that I'm going to make it to South Beach. I'm already there. I'm already going to start the trip with the end of me being on the beach. Me in my Speedo. You know, I've been working out on my body a little bit, you know. But, yeah, I already have that in my mind. And so you need to do that not just with traveling, but with your goals and your purpose. All right. You know, it means to know where you are going so that you have a better understanding where you are right now, so that the steps that you take are always in the right direction. So if I'm telling you South Beach is in South Florida, but and that's where my end destination is, it doesn't make sense if I'm in Virginia right now, it doesn't make sense to me to go take a few steps up to Canada. It doesn't make sense to me to go up towards New York, because I'm going out of I'm going a longer route than it takes to get to Florida, if that makes sense. All right? You know, it's easy to get caught up. And, you know, a lot of reasons why we get the going up to New York and Canada instead of Florida, which is the end in mind, is because of what we call activity traps. All right. It's a lot of activity traps out there. Video games. I'm a big component of video games. I love the PlayStation 4, 3, whatever. Big Call of Duty fan. I was the truth on Black Ops. And the rest of the games, you know, everybody know my gamer tag. I was always at the top. And those are what we call activity traps, because at the end of the day, I was number one on a lot of different charts. The Wolf Pack that I ran with, I was always one of the top one or two people. But at the end of all that, out of years of me playing that game, what do I have to show for it? Nothing. Nothing. I'm not even getting paid for it. I just have the memory of me doing it, and that's it. And sometimes if I talk to some of my friends now, they say, oh, you wasn't that good. You know, so that's really not even worth anything. So we got to break free from these what we call activity traps. Another activity trap is TV shows. Watch a lot of TV shows. Oh, what's going on this and what's going on that? Oh, this life is in turmoil. Oh, his life, oh, he got another baby mama and blah, 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 blah. Okay? Because at the end of the day, you are watching their life go in turmoil. You watching this particular person catch that touchdown pass, and guess how much you're getting paid for it? Nothing. Nothing. It is not making you a better football player because you watch this man catch the football touchdown. It's not making you a better businessman. It's not making you a better businesswoman. It's not making you a better mother just because you see this person treating their kids wrong. No. These are activity traps. It's just to draw your attention away from your destination. All right? Party. I used to like to party all the time, you know? And there's nothing wrong with celebrating. But if we're going through a recession, sometimes, you know, the country can go through a recession and an individual might not be going through a recession. Or sometimes a country may not going through a recession, but you might be going through a recession. So if you're going through a recession, if you got a lot of things going on, if you're in debt, if you have all, what are we partying for every weekend? What are we celebrating? What's the point? I don't think there is. All right? And just really meaningless conversations. So, you know, let's just cut all these activity traps and begin with the end in mind. But first, you got to start with what you're going to do, all right? And I want y'all to understand this. This principle, begin with the end in mind, it comes from this principle that things are created twice. Things are created twice. Now, what does that mean, all right? Things are created twice. So think about this, all right? First, there is a mental thing or spiritual, if you want to look at it. Creation. Then there's a physical creation. Mental, then physical. For instance, you're building a home. No carpenter, no company is going to put up a home without first having a blueprint. You see what I'm saying? And that blueprint is the first creation. They had to put everything down before any hammer hits, any nail. And once they had that blueprint down, then they can go ahead and take those proper steps to make that house complete. All right. So we need to start thinking about what is our blueprint for our lives. And I'm going to give you something you can start off with. All right. And these are seven areas on how you can live a fulfilling, balanced life. Number one area is your financial. You want to know how much money do you want to make? All right. Set a clear goal. And when you set these goals, put a date by it. Not only a date, but put a time. So be specific. In the next 5 years, where do you want to be? All right. So in the next 5 years, hey, let's say you want to make $100,000 a year. So put, it's 2014 right now. Next 5 years, it'd be 2019. So go ahead and put down 2019, November the 30th, 2 p.m., you want to make $100,000. You will make $100,000. You see that? Business career. That's your second thing. Business career. What do you want to do? Do you want to own a daycare? Do you want to do this? What do you want to do? Be specific. Put a date. Put a time beside that. Number three, your fun and recreation. What do you want to do? Do you want to take vacations? Do you want to take 3 vacations a year in different parts of the country? Just be very, very specific on what you want to do and how you want to do it. Put a date and time on it. All right. 4, health and wellness. Health and wellness. So, do you want to be a little bit more physically fit? Do you want to be a little buff like myself? You know. So how much weight, be specific, and how much weight do you want to lose? This is a hint. When you get that weight down, let's say you say, well, I want to lose 15 pounds. Well, if you weigh 200 pounds right now, you're trying to get down to 185. Instead of going on your scale and looking down and see 200 pounds every time you go on your scale, go ahead and cut out a piece of paper and put 185 and tape it on the top of that scale. So now, when you go in and you see 185, you're visualizing that thing. You're beginning with the end in mind. You see what I'm saying? All right. Five, your relationship. Hey, what relationship do you want to have? Do you want to be married? Do you want to have more male friends? Do you want to have more female friends? Do you want to have more business friends? So just be specific on what you want, how you want it, put a date and time on it. All right. Personal. What personal thing you want to do? You might not want to be an author, but you might want to write a book one day. That's me. I want to write a book. Okay. You might want to skydive. You might want to just do something. So name some personal things that you just want to do, some fulfilling stuff for yourself. All right. And number seven, what contribution will you leave to the world? What legacy you'll leave behind? All right. So those are some things that you can kind of start off with. All right. To just kind of get some things going, beginning with the end in mind. And I hope y'all got some good knowledge out of this today. And hey, every Friday, I'm blessing people with this word of encouragement. It's not fighting on here. I would never, you know, try to cuss somebody out or talk about anybody. But this is very uplifting information. So please like my video, share it, and leave a comment if you can. And man, God bless you. And I hope I see you at one of the two places. I'm going to see you at the bank, or I'm going to see you at the beach, baby. I catch you later. Freedom Friday, baby. Yeah.
In about 5 years.
Yeah. On this episode of Freedom Friday. Let's go, baby.